probably, you know, everybody will be quite interested in how my Akong can live until about almost 100 years old. He has a very, very routine life. At the age of 80 plus, he still take a bus all the way to Hague Road R, okay, without any problem, and we wonder how he make it.
刚好我阿公那时也是在生病嘛，那我就去看他。虽然我的阿公已经98岁了，他记性还蛮好的，我就告诉他说我是来后嘞。
He wake up at 6, he will drop by the coffee shop to take some kopi o and his some light breakfast. He will buy lunch himself. Around maybe in the afternoon, late afternoon, he'll be back. You know, sit around, have some drinks, take a short nap before he take his dinner. Exactly, it has to be exactly at 7, okay? Around 8 to 8:30, the timing is for him to sleep all the way. So the moral is sleep early, wake up early, have a routine life, you know, no alcohol, no cigarette, no smoking.
他就告诉我，然后你可以帮我去大伯公那边拜拜嘛，讨一支签。假如那个签讲我会好就好啦，假如不会好我就死了就算了啦。好几次了，我的妹妹讲不用不用求了，她已经年龄很大了，我们不要求了，我们不要了，因为她阿公要一支签嘛，不然我们求就给她一个心愿，说讲一个故事给她听讲啦。
有一次我印象最深刻就是，我看到他的手这边有 tattoo，很奇怪的 tattoo，一边是麻将的沙东，一边是麻将的果冻。他说这个是他以前年轻的时候，特别是在 Japanese occupation 抗日时期啊，他们是什么地下组织？
我就去了庙那边大伯公庙，我去求签，我一直求 ，OK， 求到了，我打那个杯啊，那个宝杯就是没有呀。那你知道那个大伯公，我就告诉他，你保佑我一支签，我有的交代给他这样。日本军看到他有什么
tattoo 就被打，你看他阿公瘦瘦的哈，他还是蛮壮的，还经得起打。每次听他说被打好几次，打得好惨，但他还是越打越壮。
现在说他真是离开人世间了，子孙满堂了，他也挺欣慰的。我们做子孙的，也为他骄傲。